nothing is better than slowly erupt. And money was burning a hole in my pocket, and honey burned a little hole in my gut. We walked in a function, they dog got the bump, and my dog got the rushing like sober your pup.
Alongside Chris Singleton, I'm John Chum. Now up for Tampa Bay, Tim Anderson. Here comes a pitch. Swings and misses. And the 2024 season has officially begun. Swing and a miss.
No ball.
And it's nothing in two.
Real ugly 0-1 swing right there. As a pitcher, got to be hunting for that strikeout. Keep him off balance. Send him back to the dugout.
Next offering upstairs.
That's a really good job of laying off the 0-2 high fastball. Is going to make that pitcher really have to respect this hitter, even though he's behind in the count.
And a 1-2 again. Anderson checks his swing. Now an appeal to first. He did not go around. Now all even up. Little dribbler up along third, and he grabs it foul. The 2-2. Hit hard, base hit. Here's Manuel Margot. In for a strike. It's 0-1.
0-1.
And ball one. Swing and a miss. One and two. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, one of the things that hitters will do is they'll look for that red dot on the baseball as it's coming in to let them know what the pitch is. And if they see the red dot, it's typically a slider. But when a guy's got a really tight one with high spin rates, very difficult to determine. And that's probably why we saw a swing and miss right there. Just a nasty pitch.
Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone. And now it's Brandon Lau. In there for strike one.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Strike two. Got him. Two out.
Well, that at-bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there, at least to foul something off, extend that at-bat.
Franmil Reyes in the box now. Takes strike one. Swing and a miss. No balls, two strikes. Just off the outside edge. Check swing. Appeal to first. No, he held up. Kicks and fires. Swing and a miss. That's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three. Here's the third baseman, Key Brian Hayes. The pitch. McClanahan, a former All-Star. He features a four-seam fastball, a changeup, a curve, and he works in a slider. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. On a line, base hit. Brian Reynolds here. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. Swings and misses. 0-1. Joe leads off first with one away. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
O'Neill Cruz in the box now. Takes strike one. late on that fastball.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boog.
And now the lefty going to count 1-2.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have...
Struck him out looking.
Well, you got to be ready to swing the bat with a runner in scoring position and two strikes. Just put the ball in play somewhere, and you got a chance. Very frustrating for him, I'm sure. See if the next guy can pick him up.
Trying to pick up his first knock in the big leagues. On the ground to the left. A dive. He's got it. Fires to first. And that's a nice play to end the inning. Back here at PNC Park. Second inning set to go. Now the left fielder, Randy Arozarena. That's in there. 0-1. That's a little bit low.
1-1.
Here's a 1-1. Bounce to the left side. They get the out on Arozarena. So here's Brown at the plate. Swings through that one. 0-1.
When you throw a fastball by a guy like that, I imagine it's got to feel incredible. Look for him to throw it again at some point.
Check swing didn't go. And that's ball one. Left-hand hitter waits. To the right side. No play, that's an infield single. And it finds its way through for a hit. Now it's Evan Longoria's turn. He swings and misses at the first pitch. 0-1.
I'm always interested in guys like Evan Longoria. He didn't have any scholarship offers out of high school, wasn't drafted out of high school, but eventually ended up at Long Beach State and became a first-round pick. How do you go from not drafted to a first-rounder?
Gabriel Moreno in the box now. No balls and a strike.
Yeah, and then becoming a superstar there for a while with the Tampa Bay Rays, and pretty incredible.
Bottom half of inning number two. Now it's the second baseman, Nick Gonzalez. In the air, foul off first. And there's one away. Adalberto Mondesi up to the plate. And first offering is fouled off.
Able to work out of a little bit of a jam in that first inning.
And the pitch.
One ball, one strike.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The wind and the pitch. And that's downed away. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. So next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Henry Davis. First offering misses badly for ball one. Looking for his first big league hit right here. Next offering misses, and now 2-0. Nothing here in the bottom of the second. And a pop up, right side, foul territory. Brown makes a nice grab at a full sprint. Back here in Pittsburgh, here's Tim Anderson. To the right side, and he picks it up and he'll put it in his pocket.
You know, Boog, I can relate to Tim Anderson with my football background and baseball background. He played Little League Baseball, but then decided to focus on basketball until he got hurt his sophomore year of high school. He then went back to baseball as a junior. 4 years later, the White Sox made him a first-round draft pick.
Tim made a good choice.
Yes, he did.
And delivers outside. Got him. One away. Manuel Margot up to the plate. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Meadows snags it for the second out. Now batting Wander Franco. Started to swing, held up. Top of the third, no score. Chopper right side. Gonzalez gets it to first. Franco gone on the play. Welcome back. Bottom of the inning at the plate for Pittsburgh. Austin Meadows. McClanahan back to work. There's a strike. And a swing and a miss there.
Going to really need to hang in there with that front side against this left-handed breaking ball.
And a pitch. Got it by him for the K.
We're going to take a look at the pitch sequence of that at bat. And the thing to notice are the pitch locations. Every single one of them on the edges of the strike zone. And as a hitter, that can be pretty frustrating because you don't expect a pitcher to be able to make quality pitches one after another like that. And so those are tough spots to do damage, and a great demonstration of pitch command, and it got him a punch out that time.
That's a hit. So a man aboard now with one away. So digging in, Connor Joe. Single to right in his first trip. Runner on the go. Pitch is high. Throw to second, tag, and they got him.
Well, I really didn't expect him to try to steal second base because he had a very standard lead at best. If you're going to try to get there safely, you've got to get more on that lead. You've got to get a better jump. That was the difference between being safe and out.
Here's a 1-1. High bounce takes it over the fence for an automatic double. And now, Brian Reynolds. And he's already singled in this game. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Well, they're looking to get on the board first here after that clutch two-out double made this inning interesting.
The lefty ready and a 1-1. And that one fouled off.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit. Just not able to square it up.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Pulls it in on the run. And that back here at the ballpark. Lau at the plate. And there's the strike.
Hoog, over 80% of his first pitches are strikes. You're doing that, you could have a really good day out there on the mound. Well, these Rays, as this game goes on, have to be more disciplined at the plate. They're chasing a lot of pitches outside the zone, and those chases are turning into a bunch of outs. Can they turn that around and stay within the zone? We'll see, but I think they have to.
Got him swinging.
With that kind of velocity and elevated fastball, even if it's still in the strike zone, can be tough for hitters to get on top of.
And it's fouled away. One down, base is empty. And that's downstairs and outside. In there at the knees. Now 1-2.
It's just been an impressive outing so far. Continues to pound the zone pitch after pitch. And he's been able to stay down. That's what's been key.
And he deals. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Had him out front for strike three. Now it's Randy Arozarena.
Randy Arozarena.
In for a strike. It's 0-1.
The guy's going this good. He's retired 7 in a row. You got to step out of the box, fake bunt, do something to break it up.
Next offering is fouled back. Next one misses. And the count is 1-2.
Two strikes.
On the retired in. And welcome back. Ready to go. Bottom four. Here's O'Neill Cruz. That's outside, and it's 1-0.
You know, these Pirates just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. So many of their outs have come from weak contact on pitches they're chasing outside of the strike zone. You can't do much of anything with those locations, and that's been true again today.
Ground ball right side. And 1-2. Outside. The 1-1 is fouled off. The next offering misses. The count now 2-2. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Some heat there at 98 miles an hour. Nick Gonzalez, the next Pirate to hit. First time up was a pop out. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one.
This guy's usually not one to chase pitches off the plate, but he did there. We'll see if he can tighten up his zone a little bit.
The next pitch misses, and now it's even 1-1. Two down, nobody on. Good eye right there.
Two balls, one strike.
Swing and a miss as he was late that time. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And good work there as he gets it. Back here at PNC Park, and now the first baseman, Seth Brown. Ball one, no strikes.
Well, these Rays, as this game goes on, have to be more disciplined at the plate. Chasing pitches has been a big part of the story. We've seen it quite a bit today. It's been tough for them to make contact at times, and it just doesn't look like they're seeing it very well as a group.
There's a swing and a drive. Reynolds ranging back, looking up, and in one hops the wall. And that's a double.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it. Now let's see if they can put up the first.
With nobody out. Righty to the plate. And just misses with that one. And now the count filled up 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound, but you know his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this, but he's going to have to buckle down right here.
Just missed. Swing and a line drive curling foul down the right side. Swing and a miss as he was late. First and second here, no outs. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Had him out front for strike three. So the lineup flips over. Tim Anderson will hit next. In there, and it's 0-1. And a swing and a miss. Anderson down on strikes.
It came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time a little anxious.
To third, Hayes. Jump throw. Third out. That ends the frame. Two left. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a foul straight back.
You know, these Pirates just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. Chasing pitches has been a big part of the story. We've seen it quite a bit today. It's been tough for them to make contact at times, and it just doesn't look like they're seeing it very well as a group.
And the 0-2. Back up the... Oh, that got him! Safe. He beats it out, and the go-ahead run is on to start the inning. Henry Davis, the next Pirate to hit. He popped out his first time. Runner takes off. There's a ball. Throw, safe! That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
On the ground, right side. Throw on to Brown. And that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth.
And on the mound, you know confidence has to be pretty high with all of the swings and misses. He's had them eaten out of the palm of his hand pretty much all game.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air, shallow left field. Drops into the glove. Runner tags from third. The throw's offline. He's safe. On the board first, it's one zip.
Well, we finally have a score in this ball game. Sac fly, nice job of manufacturing a run, and that could end up being a big run at this rate.
Fly ball center field. That gets down for a hit, and that extends the inning.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time, and guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
Hayes off of first with two away. Got him. Good job at damage control right there. Back here in Pittsburgh, all set for the top of the sixth. Here's Wander Franco. First pitch, not close. Softly hit to third, and he picks it up in foul territory. Here's a 1-1. Ground ball, left side. Hayes to first. Now one gone in the top of the sixth. Next to hit, Brandon Lau. Pitches in there, and that's strike one. Lau measures 5 feet, 10 inches, 185 pounds, and he was a third round pick back in 2015. Next offering misses, now 1-2. In the air, center field. Reynolds gets under it. Hauls it in for the out. Now it's Franmil Reyes. Bounce to the right. Gonzalez. Whips it to first. And that is that. Re-up. Bottom of the sixth inning. At the plate for Pittsburgh, Brian Reynolds. And he handles it himself.
Very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
Cruz, the batter now, as he swings and misses for strike one. Oh. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Just an outstanding job of spinning the baseball, moving it around, doing what he does.
Next one just misses. 1-2 to count. And another ball.
Two balls, two strikes.
Struck him out swinging. Some high cheese for strike three. Bob Hook, the next Pirate to hit. That's a laser base hit. Bob Hook with his first major league hit, and this is a moment I'm sure he'll never forget. Congrats.
Yeah, great moment for him and his family. Long for this to happen, and when it does, it can kind of be overwhelming, dude. You still have to stay locked in on the game, but it's great when you can take a minute to just appreciate what you've done and how hard you've worked to get here.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Out number three, Pirates lead. We go to the top of the seventh. Here's the left fielder, Randy Arozarena. And first offering is fouled off. There's a strike.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
That's the third. Tosses across the first. They get the out on Arozarena. Into box again, takes a strike.
That curveball's been a big pitch for him today. He's been able to get ahead in the count with it. He's also been able to use it to put guys away.
And that one finds its way through. And that puts the tying run on base. Runner on at first with one gone. Evan Longoria next to hit for the Rays. And that one is in for a strike. Grounder might be two. Fires to second for one. Double play. They can't seem to break through. Inning over.
Poetry in motion there as the second baseman turns the double play. Nice throw to first, and that's the
bottom of the seventh, and now at Alberto Mondesi. The pitch. Down to the dirt, swing and a miss.
Usually when a pitcher's had a dominant outing, he has filled up the strike zone and he's gotten ahead in the count with first pitch strikes. Well, that's exactly what this guy has done in this one. Over 70% first pitch strikes.
1-1 now. That one the other way. Makes the catch. One down. Henry Davis, the next Pirate to hit. Ryan Thompson warming up for manager Kevin Cash. Clevinger getting loose as well. That one misses, and that's ball two. And that's outside.
A rare three ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. Henry Davis with his first major league hit, and this is a moment I'm sure he'll never forget. Congrats.
Yeah, great moment for him and his family. A guy works so hard.
Runner on the go. Pitch misses inside. Throw to second. Ow!
Man, I see him trying to be aggressive right there late in this ball game, trying to add on to that lead. You know, I really like the thought, but it just didn't work out that time. Nice job by the defense right there to keep things right where they are in terms of the score.
The pitch. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. The wide, the kick, and the 1-2. Ripped to third, but handled. And that'll end the inning. back here at the ballpark. We go to the eighth, and the batter now, Gabriel Moreno. The wind of the pitch. And first offering is fouled off. The tying run at the plate. The other way. Oh, and he whiffs on it.
Way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Little trouble with this one behind the plate. Nothing doing. Count moves to 1-1. Moreno gets his lead at first with nobody out.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay.
Got him! Down on strikes, and he knew it. Now the number two hitter, Manuel Margot. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Well, just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game.
Bounced, and that got the pitcher.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
Bronco up to bat next, lays off for a ball. Runner at second, two down. Next offering is in for a strike. In there for a strike at the bottom of the zone. The 1-1 is fouled off.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch. Keep the bat alive.
Brings it in with a nice running grab. And now a new pitcher for the Rays, Ryan Thompson.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
The pitch. Swings through that one out in front that time. The 0-2. Good job to fight that one off. The 0-2. The punch out there, and he's down on strikes for the second time today. Connor Joe, the next Pirate to hit.
Went down looking on three pitches last time. Let's see if he can be a little more aggressive right here.
First offering misses the mark. A little out front there as he swings through it. And a 1-1. That one to first. Nice grab. The throw, and that's a great play for the out. Up next for the Pirates, Brian Reynolds. 1-for-3. Swing and a foul straight back. And the righty deals. On the ground, right side. Lau sends it to first. Play made. That ends the inning. We go to the ninth. Here's the second baseman, Brandon Lau. Dwayne Underwood Jr. gets the call from the pen.
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down a win. So this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
Next offering is foul back. At the belt and fires. That one off the mark. It's a ball and two strikes. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. So up next, Franmil Reyes. That's in there. And it's 0-1. Liner snagged at first.
Nothing you can do about those as a hitter. Even though you know that, they still drive you absolutely crazy.
And there's a foul ball. Here's the 0-2. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Well, this one was all about the pitching and defense. Outstanding job of the pitchers, really attacking hitters, trusting what the catcher was putting down, and trusting the guy standing behind him to make the plays defensively. Sometimes you want to see a high-scoring game, but sometimes you can appreciate the artistic beauty of what these guys did on the mound today.
And a 1-0 final score here in this one. They hang on to win it by a run. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.